Good evening, parishioners and friends of St. Francis Xavier Church. My name is Patricia, and I welcome you to our Eucharistic celebration of the fifth Sunday in Ordinary Time. In today's Gospel, Jesus uses the images of salt and light to describe the life of a disciple. He generously declares that all of his followers are in fact salt and light, there to heal division, preserve the world from injustice and oppression, and enhance the flavor of life by influencing the world in a positive way. In this way, Jesus teaches that there is sanctity in ordinary human lives. In this Mass, we pray for the intentions of all parishioners and friends of our parish. Please stand and join in the parish prayer. O God, eternal Lord of all things, you created humanity in your image and likeness, and you so loved the world that you gave your only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in him might have life and have it to the fullest. Grant that, in imitation of the servant of Christ, St. Francis Xavier, who carried the good news of salvation to many people, we may courageously proclaim your word and be the salt of the earth and light of the world. Amen.
We pray for Albert Belly, whom God called home 2 days ago, that the Almighty God grant Albert Belly eternal rest. And we pray for Rose Himpala, that anniversary, Almighty God grant Rose eternal rest. And we pray for Margaret Belly, Kim Lord, Noella, and Jim Shan for healing, grace, and blessings and protection. And for the family intentions and personal intentions of Conception and Cheta, Christian Okoye, Obinna Okoye for transformation and God's grace, Jenny Caspers, Ramona Women, Miriam Rejandran, Jess and family, Liju Korean and family, Janet Lewis, Sue Hunt, Pam, and Paula Dagama Pinto and family. The Almighty God grant them their heart desire and protect them. And for our own different intentions, that the Almighty God grant us all whatever we ask in faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and in the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory be to God in the highest. Peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, the Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry and shelter the homeless poor. Clothe the man you see to be naked and turn not from your own kin. Then will your light shine like the dawn and your wound be quickly healed over. Your integrity will go before you and the glory of the Lord behind you. Cry, and the Lord will answer. Call, and he will say, I am here. If you do away with the yoke, the clenched fist, the wicked word, if you give your bread to the hungry and relief to the oppressed, your light will rise in the darkness and your shadows become like noon. The word of the Lord.
Please join in on the responsorial psalm. A light rises in the darkness for the upright. He is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. The good man takes pity and lends. He conducts his affairs with honor. The just man will never waver. He will be remembered forever. He has no fear of evil news. With a firm heart, he trusts in the Lord. With a steadfast heart, he will not fear. Open-handed, he gives to the poor. His justice stands firm forever. His head will be raised in glory. A light rises in the darkness for the upright.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers, it was not with any show of oratory or philosophy, but simply to tell you what God had guaranteed. During my stay with you, the only knowledge I claimed to have was about Jesus and only about him as the crucified Christ. Far from relying on any power of my own, I came among you in great fear and trembling. And in my speeches and the sermons that I gave, There were none of the arguments that belonged to the philosophy, only a demonstration of the power of the Spirit. And I did this so that your faith should not depend on human philosophy, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt becomes tasteless, what can make it salty again? It is good for nothing and can only be thrown out to be trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on the lampstand where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in the sight of men, so that seeing your good works, they may give praise to your Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. The Lord is good all the time. Sometimes in life, we feel that we are nobody, that we are not gifted, that God has not given us some gifts to share. But today, we are now told that we have a very serious and very big gifts to share with people around us. Share with the hungry, share with the less privileged, share, be a light. For if you yoke yourself with Christ, the light of the world, Christ's light will shine out from you to people around you. That's why on this fifth Sunday of ordinary time, the Holy Mother Church reminds us that she is a light in the dark. That she equally reminds us, her children, that the light will be brighter if all Christians were really like Christ. If we follow Christ, trust Christ, live out like Christ, Christ's light will shine out through us. That's why in the first reading, the prophet Isaiah tells us what we must do for our light to shine out. Share your bread with the hungry. For when you are sharing your bread with the hungry, you put smiles on their faces and they see the goodness, graciousness, and the light of Christ in their lives. And he says, shelter the homeless. For where you shelter the homeless, those living on the margins, those who have nowhere to lay their heads, you are sheltering Christ. And the light of the divine mercy, light of the divine Christ, will shine out. He tells us also, Isaiah said, clothe the naked. Who are the naked? Some are spiritually naked. Some are physically naked. How do you care for them? Have you a compassionate spirit? Have you a humble life, sharing, self-giving, letting them know they are somebody, that God loves them also as he loves you? That's why these form the church's corporal works of mercy. The United Nations declared them as ecumenical and fundamental human rights in 1948. They are the basic necessities of life. So their deprivation robs humanity of her dignity and leaves her in perpetual darkness. This would amount to structural injustice, as well as a sin against charity. Therefore, we must be that good man who is light in the dark for upright. We must represent Christ well, be good ambassadors of Christ and good ambassadors of the church, sharing, showing, and living. In the second reading of today, St. Paul testified that he was light to the Corinthians. His presence illuminated their darkness. Also, as salt, he helped in preserving their salvation. He did this not only through his words, but through his actions. For action speaks louder than words. He recalled thus, when I came to you, brothers and sisters, it was not with any show of oratory or philosophy, but simply to tell you what God has granted. St. Paul did this in a very simple way, through his words and good works. Can we represent Christ and represent the church by good works, living lives of justice and integrity, being the light and salt to people around us? And can we represent Christ being Christian and being human, self-giving? St. Paul proved to be indeed the light through which the pagan Corinthians saw the light of Christ. He was the salt which sweetened and preserved their lives. Therefore, our encounter with people must leave them better than we met them. It must wipe off the dust of worry, shame, despair, and disappointment in their lives. It must liberate them from ignorance and help them to appreciate the truth by drawing close to God. Through our lives, we'll bring them closer to the living God, closer to salvation, to experience the living, to experience Christ himself. In the gospel reading of today, Jesus calls us salt. In the Old Testament, salt was used to season the sacrificial offerings for the sins and covenant with God. In the book of Leviticus, it says, season all your grain offerings with salt. You shall not let the salt of the covenant with your God be lacking from your cereal offering. Also, land agreements were sealed with a gift of salt as a proof of the strength and permanence of the contract. Salt was also a symbol of God's activity in a person's life. This is because it penetrates, preserves, and aids in healing. That is how God becomes active in our lives. So when Christ calls us salt, he wants us to make a difference in our world. We must penetrate, preserve our world from moral, spiritual, and physical or environmental decay. As salts, we must add taste and flavor to people's lives. Whoever tastes us, whoever experiences us, must be transformed and changed. Change from darkness to light. Change from bitterness to being sweet through our own lives, our own relationship, and our own encouragement, words of encouragement, and our own compassionate spirit given to them. Again, Christ calls us light. In fact, he gives us a command. Your light must shine in the sight of men and women. Light does not shine for itself. Hence, Christ tells us why we must shine, so that men and women may see your good works and give praise to God. For when we live out our own good lives, shine out Christ to them, they will praise God and thank God for his graciousness and for being with them and serving them. Let us remember, good works here means corporal and spiritual works of mercy, as we saw them in our first reading. To give praise means to acknowledge and to be moved. Acknowledge the presence of God and to move with compassion. It means to be affected positively by our light. As light, we must represent what is good, what is pure, what is true, what is holy, and what is reliable. We ask ourselves, are we reliable? Are we really the true light on which Christ will use to shine to the world and shine in the lives of all who experience you and whom you will experience? Are you a true Christian living out your Christian transparent lives? Lives of faith and integrity. Finally, we must not conceal God's gift. God has given each and every one of us different kinds of gifts. We must share. Since charity begins at home, so we must first be light and salt in our homes and communities. Also, our world must feel the positive effects of our light. We must not starve it of the sweetness of our testimonies and good works. We ask our good Lord to give us the grace, the strength, the blessings, and the power to be the true light to people around us, true light to the world, and be the salt of the earth, sweeten the lives of all who experience us and of all whom we will experience. For God will shine out through us and show that he is truly our God and he is good. Let us stand to proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, mighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Prayers of intercession. Sisters and brothers, across Australia, this day is being observed as the Sunday of the Word of God, with a theme given by Pope Francis, "We proclaim what we have seen."
That the Word of God, proclaimed by Pope Francis, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and the Moderator General of the Church of Scotland in South Sudan, on an ecumenical peace pilgrimage, will bring the blessings of Christ's peace and harmony to all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That as Pope Francis celebrates the Eucharist with the Catholics of South Sudan this Sunday morning, they will experience unity around the table of God's Word and the table of the Eucharist. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That the Word of God will activate lives of personal integrity and of service to others, so that Christ's light shines through us and the flavor of his salt preserves truth and beauty in all hearts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That our sick family members and friends, Riley Kemp, James Asherson, will be comforted in their suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That our recently departed, Rosario Cruz, Walter Schmitz, the suffering souls in purgatory, and those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time, Rob Smith, will enter that heavenly home which is promised to those who hear the word of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pause and pray with our hearts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Let us surrender our own personal prayers and petitions to the loving God. And all the dead we are praying for in this Mass, God grant them eternal rest. The sick, God will grant healing and strength and grace. The families we are praying for, God will bless them and transform, and visit them and transform their situations and bring them hope and blessings. And for our own needs and the needs of all those we promise to pray for, and those who ask us to pray for them, we surrender everything unto the Lord through the intercession of our Blessed Mother Mary as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Eternal Father, your word, whom we have heard in this Eucharist, and seen with the eyes of faith, and touched in the care of the poor, is our life. May this reality draw us into unity and make our joy complete, and grant us all whatever we ask in faith, through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Amen. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your holy name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When it is bread. Again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her glorious spouse, with their blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Francis Xavier, and with all the saints, of whose constant intercession in your presence we rely from failing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you, Lord. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, especially Albert Belly, Rose Himpala, and all the holy souls in purgatory, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, as it is in heaven. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we are waiting in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, who are the sins of the world, behold Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, my soul shall be healed. By the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Second collection, please. Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live, that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We use this opportunity to welcome back all those who came back from just holidays. They have they traveled overseas and they enjoyed it themselves. Now they are back. Yeah, welcome back. And today is the birthday. Tomorrow is the birthday of one of our little ones. Eh? We give her an applause. Let her grow in strength and in grace, strong to defend the faith everywhere. The Lord be with you. Go in the peace of Christ, for this Mass is ended. Thank you for coming, and I wish you a very good and wonderful evening, wonderful day tomorrow, and wonderful week. Sweet dreams, eh? God bless you. Thank you. Yeah.